Now, let me get a handle on this. Now, as I understand it, either we buy all our booze off you for $120 a case, or we'll be sorry. Is that the gist of it?
You will be very sorry.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Well, you must excuse me. I don't grasp things as quickly as my international partner. When you say that we'll be sorry, just how sorry will we be?
Let me put it this way. There have been one or two bars who've decided not to do business with us. You wouldn't know these places because, unfortunately, they no longer exist.
Run a bad luck, huh?
Very bad luck.
Oh.
And so near their opening, too. I remember one place, a very good-looking club, too, but exactly 1 week after opening night, they had a fire.
Nothing minor, I hope.
Burned to the ground. Then there was another. A charming man ran it, but he, too, decided not to buy from us.
Oh, golly. Not a fire?
No. A rather sudden death in the family.
These are hard times.
That's why it pays to have insurance.
Mm.
Yes. And insurance is, of course, buying liquor from you.
I don't believe I could have put it better myself. Now, may I assume we have a deal?
Oh, I think we know what to do. Mm. Don't you, Robert?
Ah, absolutely, partner. Do you think we should do it now?
No time like the present.
Yes.
A one, and a two,
and a three.
I think we forgot to ask him something.
What?
Can he swim?
If I may say so, I'm delighted to see you two together again.
Well, that's very kind of you, but Dr. Quartermain and I are together only for lunch.
Oh, I beg your pardon. I just assumed when you came in together.
Oh, no, it's all right. It's very easy to jump to wrong assumptions. I mean, we do it all the time, don't we, Doctor?
Constantly, Doctor.
Poor girl. I can understand her confusion.
Yes, so could I. Because at the moment, I'm suffering from an acute attack of déjà vu.
Oh, really? I hope you're not suffering too badly.
No, I am being confused, that's for sure. See, I can't recall if I'm reliving the times when we were fighting like cats and dogs or whether we were pledging our eternal devotion.
Well, we did both on occasion.
As I know. I guess at the moment, I'm really recalling the better moments, rather than the bitter ones.
You have a one-track mind.
You always said I did.
Yes, but I'm sure I never said it in one of the bitter moments.
Were there really that many bad moments?
Well, I recall them all very vividly. Especially the bitter ones. Well, not especially. This isn't one of the bitter ones. You see, the bitter ones, your eyes would absolutely light up and you became like an enraged tigress. And then I knew I was about to receive it with both barrels.
Well, you held your own beautifully.
I tried.
So, do I look like an enraged tigress to you right now?
No, not at the moment. But do not misconstrue this for complacency, because I know you all too well, Monica. And I know how easily your moods change, and you do it like greased lightning.
All right. You're absolutely right. So I'll make you a promise. Mm-hmm. You swear. I shall promise that I will not become an enraged tigress. At least until after coffee. So tell me something. Aren't you at all curious as to why I asked you for lunch?
Why bother? I know you're going to tell me.
It's about Christmas. You do realize that it would mean a great deal to your mother and to your son if you would have Christmas dinner at the house.
I know.
And I realize that it's complicated, but you can rest assured that we'll do everything to make it comfortable for you. In fact, Lotta has said that she'll have dinner whatever time is convenient for you.
There can't be an easy time, Monica. They seem happy, don't they?
Well, it's a common condition on your wedding day. It's too bad it doesn't last.
Wait, it's
okay. It's fine, thank you.
Tonight.
Watch it, fella.
I'm talking about the ceremony.
Oh.
The ceremony.
Oh, all right.
Okay.
Okay, tell me what Mike said.
Oh, Mike was very thrilled. I mean, he was really thrilled. Then he said, what is the best man?
Boy, sometimes I look at people who have children and I get upset. I think it's not fair. They don't even know what they have.
We are very fortunate. We're going to have Mike, we have Laura and Amy.
When I hear you say we're going to have Mike that way, it makes me believe it's really going to happen.
We are, Lesley. I promise you that.
I sure hope so, because if we don't get Mike, if we lose him, I don't know what'll happen to you.
Well, I want Mike. I want him very much, but sometimes I think you put that just a little out of proportion.
In what way?
Lesley, I want a son, and Mike is as great a son as any man could ever want. But to have Mike without having you would be absolutely meaningless.
Thank you. That's very important to know. Thank you.
I mean it.
Sometimes I can't help it. I do get very frightened that we're going to lose him.
Lesley, we're not going to lose him. I'm not that much of a fatalist, but I really believe in my heart that he was meant to be part of our family.
I do,
He's
too.
Going to be.
I believe that. I had another very serious thought today.
Oh, you want me to guess?
No, I don't. No, I want to tell you.
Okay.
I'm going to work very, very hard to see that our marriage is a great success, and that is a very solemn promise.
You don't mind if I make one slight correction in that,
mm-hmm.
Dave? We are going to work very hard.
Excuse us. We have much to say.
Hi.
How happy you both look.
That is because we are very happy.
Well, this is probably a couple of hours premature, but I want to congratulate the both of you, really.
Thank you,
Thank you, Emma.
That goes
Thank
for
you.
Both of us. Thank you, Monica.
More than welcome.
We'll see you.
Okay.
Isn't it funny seeing those two together?
Yes, it's funny.
I would say that the Lord may work in mysterious ways, but he certainly seems to know what he's doing.
Your hair looks lovely.
Thank you. I suffered, but it was worth it, I sincerely hope. Did you hurt your back?
Me? No,
why?
Why are you leaning funny like that?
Funny? Like that?
Well, I kind of wanted it to be a surprise, but... Ta-da!
Oh! Oh, look at that! That is so beautiful! I can't cry. I can't cry. If I cry, I'm going to have red eyes for my own
Don't
wedding.
Cry. Don't cry.
That is the most beautiful cake I have ever seen in my life.
Thank you. I had a hard time keeping Mike
too.
Keeping his little fingers out of it, too.
Yeah, where's Mike?
Oh, he's upstairs. He was so excited. He was just all over the kitchen.
Yeah? Where's Amy?
She's upstairs, too, and... Amy's fixing her own hair, so only the dear Lord knows.
You were here early. How lovely.
Thank you.
What a cake. Mrs. Grant, that's gorgeous. Did you make it yourself?
Yes, I did. Thank you. And I want you both to remember to keep your fingers out of it till after the I do's.
Hey, do I look like a person who would eat cake early?
Both keep your fingers out of it. I'm going to go see the flowers.
Silly person. Isn't it terrific? I was this close. I just almost cried.
No, Mom. I don't believe you. Honest to God, sometimes you behave just like a little child.
I know. I feel like a child, and it's wonderful.
Do you?
Yeah.
You know, that's funny that you should say that, because all the way over here, I was thinking to myself, my mom and dad are getting married, right?
Yeah.
So how come I feel like the mother of the bride? I do. and I also feel like the mother of the groom. It's really weird.
I know what you mean. I was sort of thinking along the same lines today. I was thinking, just a couple of weeks ago, I was the mother of the bride, and I was a little bit nervous, you can understand this. And today, I'm the bride, and I'm panicking. You got me, too?
No, I really don't. I have a wish for you, though.
What?
Come on, you know what it is. I don't even have to say it. Do you have any idea how how terrific it is for me to know that my parents are getting back together again.
And it wasn't easy.
I know, but it's so beautiful. I just want you to be happy.
That we will be.
I promise you.
For the ceremony, is that dumb?
No, that's great. I love it.
Okay, listen, you could be a big help.
Uh-huh.
Go inside, get your father, take him down to where those big poinsettia trees are, and keep him facing the French doors, and then I'll sneak through the room and up the stairs, okay?
Okay, all right, I'll do that.
You sure this is not stupid?
No, it's wonderful. It's beautiful.
Okay.
Best for luck, okay? Ready?
Okay, thanks a lot.
Okay. Dad, hi. Isn't this exciting?
Yes, it is.
I'm so happy for you. The yard looks absolutely gorgeous.
Oh, well, thank you.
So, you and Mom are going to be there? Is that where you're going to be?
Well, no. What we really thought we'd do is be inside here. See the flowers? We're going to do it right here.
Oh, I thought you were going to come in from...
No.
Get the ring.
Hey, look at my best
hi,
man,
Mike.
Will you? You are very handsome.
Thank you.
Yeah, you look terrific. Very grown up.
Well, a best man has to be grown up, but he has to wear this dumb necktie, and I don't know how.
Well, that's where I come in handy.
Okay.
Over here, about face, sit down, and I'll attempt to... Oh, boy, okay.
Dr. Rick, I still have the ring. I kept it in my pocket all day, and I was holding on to it also.
You are something else, guy.
And he has looked at it every 5 minutes.
Well, they couldn't get married without me in the ring.
Right.
That is absolutely true.
You know what I think? I think that your best man could probably use a little nourishment to get through all this. How about maybe some brownies that I have in the kitchen? Would that be all right?
They're my favorite.
Now, how do you suppose I guess that?
Not too tight, is it?
Come on.
I'll finish you later, guy.
Okay, see you later, Doctor.
Okay. Would you excuse the groom? Then I'll go upstairs. I'm trying to make myself a little presentable. A little better than I am. Handsome, maybe.
You already look handsome.
Great. Where's my suit, Tom? Did you see where I left my suit?
Well, it's probably...
I left it up here, sorry.
Amy, your hair. Do you like it?
Yeah, I love it. Who did it?
I did it myself. I looked at a picture in a magazine. You don't think it's too much, do you?
No, it's great. I think it's you. It's beautiful.
Thanks.
Doesn't this room look beautiful?
Very, very beautiful.
You know, I really love wedding. You want to know why?
Another chance to catch the bouquet?
Well, that too.
Mm-hmm.
Except that at a wedding, everybody is so nice and dressed up and so happy. And well, I guess what I'm trying to say is that on a wedding day, it's not just the bride and the groom that are happy, but everybody is.
Apologize to you. I shot off my mouth this morning, and I really acted disgracefully like a chauvinistic pig, which I am not. I apologize. Please forgive me.
Of course, forgive you.
Thanks.
And you're right. The contract does demand too much of my time. I thought that I could take it to Joe, you know, and work it out so that I can spend more time with you.
That's all I wanted ever.
Hello.
Happy wedding day.
What an exciting day. Thank you, Alice. Very much. I'm really looking forward to
it. Oh, beautiful. Hi.
Oh, it's so pretty.
Look at this. Looks like a baby sister with news, doesn't it? I hope it's good.
Oh, well, it's a lot better than good. It's incredible.
Tell him.
Well, Dr. Bradshaw has just given me a position as head of pediatrics in one of the best hospitals in New York.
Oh, that's great. Congratulations.
And it's New York. We get to see her.
Oh, rats. And I was hoping she was going to Tierra del Fuego. I'm happy for you, baby.
So am I, Bobby, and that's great because we'll get to see a lot of each other. Oh, my gosh. Look at this.
Hi, Joe. Did you make it?
Wow.
Pretty good.
Are you kidding? Any woman would be crazy to pass up a man like you.
Fortunately, your mother feels that way. Oh, I think His Honor is here. Would you all excuse me, please?
Go get him, Tiger.
I'll come with you.
John.
Rick.
Thank you.
I told you, Rick, this will be a privilege. Now, tell me,
How's your sports center coming along?
It's coming along very, very nicely.
Well, with you behind it, I don't doubt it for a minute.
Excuse us. Mr. Mayor, nice to see you. We haven't seen you since our wedding.
Hi. It's so wonderful to see you.
Good to see you.
Looks like everything is working out just fine with you.
Perfect, sir.
Yeah.
Well, I'm marrying a woman who's very punctual, and I believe that this is the time I'm supposed to be in the kitchen alone, so I will leave you all here. It means the fatal hour is near, right? Yes, Tom.
You'll survive.
Thanks.
You're excused. So,
I think, according to the schedule, you all are supposed to be out there, and I'm supposed to be in here locked up alone.
Well, gosh, Rick, when am I going to stand up for you like you said?
You keep an eye on me, and I'll give you the high sign, okay?
Okay.
We'll be just fine.
Come on.
Okay.
Joe, it's Rick. You know, I was just hoping maybe you had some last word from that attorney. No, I understand, of course. I just hope we might be able to tell Mike something. Yes, today is a very special day, and if I could tell him he's going to be our son, it would be... I'm sure you understand, yes. Fine, we'll just have to wait. Yeah. Oh, thank you very much.
Dr. Rick, you're ready.
Well, I'm ready, too. Shall we do it?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Lesley, Rick, I know I need not remind you of the meaning of marriage, for you have discovered it for yourselves. And by your commitment today, show us you truly know its worth. You begin this adventure with a distinct advantage. For you knew deep commitment to one another in the past. You know it now, in the present. And you will cherish it in the future. Will you, Richard Weber, take this woman, Lesley Weber, to be your lawful wedded wife?
I will.
And will you, Lesley Weber, take this man, Richard Weber, to be your lawful wedded husband?
Well.
The ring, please. Insomuch as Richard and Lesley have come together in front of this company and have sworn each to the other their vow. By the power vested in me by the state of New York, I do now proclaim they are husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.